Good afternoon. My name is Jun Byo. I'm working for Korea Atomic Energy Research Institute. The title of my presentation is a novel isolation method of cellulose nanocrystals from microcrystalline cellulose. As you know, the cell is the most abundant, renewable, biocompatible, and biodegradable organic polymer, which is isolated in the viscous archaic nanofibrils or microfibrils. The cellulose is a linear polymer composed of glucose, which is the with the lifting unit of the cell bio Z. And by microcrystalline cellulose is a purified residue with a highly crystallinity and partially depolymerized powder, which can be obtained through the acid hydrolysis from wood and cotton. And this slide shows the cumulative scientific publication regarding the nanocellulose. As you can see from this graph, so many research regarding the nanocellulose increased dramatically. Cellulose nanocrystals, so called the CNC, is the crystalline region in Bohson cells. And the CNC is the rod-like shape, and their size is typically reported by the diameter of 5 to 20 nanometers, and the length distribution of 100 to 600 nanometers. And acid hydrolysis has been common use for CNC isolation. And CNC can be isolated from a variety of sources such as cotton, kenyan, jute, and pulp. And CNC can be used for the polymer green composite and scaffold for tissue engineering and then coating and films due to the low density and excellent mechanical properties and nanoscale reinforcement and biocompatibility and biodegradability. However, many limitations of the CNC isolation process is still need to be improved, such as the time consumption process and low yield with the duration of the hydrolysis time. I briefly introduced the radiations. The radiation is a form of energy that is emitted from a source and travels in the form of waves or particles through the mediums. And radiation can be divided into non-ionizing radiation and ionizing radiations. And non-ionizing radiation is low energy radiation that cannot produce the ionization. And ionizing radiation is high energy radiation that can produce ionization. So alpha particle, beta particle, electron, gamma ray, and X-rays are belong to ionizing radiation. A chemical reaction caused by radiation involved the polymerization and cross-syncing of the monomer and oligomers, and degradation is caused by the oxidation and other forms of degradation. And then oxidation and the change seasons frequently occur simultaneously. And grafting is a chemical reaction processing by the polymerization of new monomers and the attachment of new polymer to the basis polymer. Curing is the process in which three-dimensional networks form. So our study is focused on the development of novel isolation method of CNC by electron beam treatments, so that we wanted to reduce the CNC isolation time and also improve the CNC hydrolysis yield. This is the CNC isolation procedures. MCC was hydrolyzed by sulfuric acids for 60, 90, 120 minutes, and the suspension was cooled with the ionizing water to stop the reactions. And the dialysis was conducted by the dialysis tubing cellulose membrane, and then ultrasonic treatment was carried out to disperse the suspension and freeze dry. Abi cell pH 101 was used for the microcrystalline cellulose source, and the Abi cell was irradiated by using electron beam accelerator with the electron beam energy of 2.5 mega electron volt and 25 milliampere and the line speed of 10 meter per minute, which is provided 25 kilogram per pulse, and total oxygen dose was 50, 100, 150, and 200 kilogram. And the molecular weight of the MCC was characterized by using the GPC analysis, and the average particle size was measured by using particle size analyzer. And then crystalline index value was calculated by using the XRD analysis, and then the thermal properties of MCC and CNC was characterized by using the TGA analysis, TGA. And the morphology was observed by using the TEM. This is the result. This slide shows the effect of electron beam on the molecular weight and crystallinity. As you can see from these tables, with increasing the radiation dose, the weight of molecular weight, so weight average molecular weight is decreased dramatically. However, the crystalline index decreased slightly from 80 to 55. This slide shows average particle size. As a result, the crystal CNC was obtained from non-irradiated MCC after 120 minutes hydrolysis time. However, the CNC from 50 Gregory Leda samples was obtained just 30 minutes of hydrolysis time. This slide shows the CNC yield, and then the CNC yield for the 50 Gray Leda samples shows the higher value than that of non-irradiated sample. However, with increasing the radiation dose, the CNC yield was decreased. This is the X-ray XRD results. The results exhibit a similar diffraction pattern, and the crystallinity index was about 80% for 50 Gray Leda sample and 78% for non-irradiated sample. The lower crystallinity value is related to the long duration of the hydrolysis time. This slide shows the TGA and TTGA analysis region. And as you can see from this graph, the thermal properties of CNC is lower than that of MCC. And then, however, the triad was much higher than that of the MCC. In addition, based on the DTG curves, the peak temperature of the thermal decomposition is for the electron irradiated sample is much higher than that of the non-irradiated sample. And this same image shows that the successful isolation of rod-like shaped CNC, and the observed diameter was about 20. Nanometers. This is a summary. The electron beam irradiation method employed for the isolation of CNC from MCC was successful. And morphologically, the isolated CNC was rod-like shape with a size of 330 nanometers, yield of 51%, and then crystallinity index of 8% for the 50 Gray Leda samples. And electron beam irradiation decreased the degree of polymerization and the crystallinity of the MCC. And CNC was isolated for around just 30 minutes using irradiation pretreatment method. And electron beam irradiation is the facial and environmental treatment for determining the efficiency of the hydrolysis process. And that's all. Thank you for your attention.
how is
gray?
Ah.
Actually, well, the 50 gray, 100 to 150 and 20 kilogram.
There is any limitation for the study? This muscle grows like that.
Limitation?
Yeah.
Actually, there is no limitation, but as you can see from here, with the increasing the radiation dose, that the CNC was decreased. That's why we didn't increase the more.
Okay, okay. I'm working on electron beam radiation on as a aspect of research best management.
Sorry?
You know, I'm using electron beam radiation using microtrans.
Ah, yeah.
As an effective method for pest control management.
Okay.
So part of my project, I'm working on that.
Okay.
Your colleagues, anybody working on, your institute, anybody working on entomology? Using insect for studying biological changes in the insect and any organism after electron beam radiation. In your institute that you are based near?
Yeah, we also have the division treating the these kinds of the work and also biotechnology.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, thank you. Your thesis is for the postdoc? Your faculty and PhD student?
I'm senior researcher.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. So, what I understand this presentation is like some novel method, no? Of cellulose nanocrystal, something like that. So, I just want to ask one question. The questions. For example, when you use the ultrasonic for the extraction, which kind of ultrasonic? Is a probe or with a bath ultrasonic?
Ultrasonication?
Yes, because we have a different method in ultrasonic when you extraction. Some method, the efficiency is more than others. I just want to ask if you use the bath ultrasonic or probe. This you can inside your sample and shaking.
You mean explain about
yes,
this procedure?
Yes.
Yeah, actually this procedure was carried out just for remove the remained the sulfuric acid.
This first means sonic only, probe only.
Sonication.
Yeah.
Yeah, so just sonication in the bath.
So these nanocrystals.
Yes.
So what the aim? What is the future application of the nanocrystals?
You mean the application?
Yes, the future application.
Yeah, actually, it's the there are so many applications using the nanocells and separate for lithium battery
yes,
display.
Because I'm really interested in this sensor, definitely this. Okay,
yeah.
Thank you very much. So, did you do some study about optical property using like some data like quantum physics data like energy, something like that, optical property studies?
Actually, is that we didn't get enough the CNC, so that's why we can make the transparency paper. Yes. We will try.
Yes, I think as a nanocrystal is environment friendly, it's okay.
Yeah, right.
It can be used to avoid some problem because sometimes you use some chemical that is harmful. Yes.
CNC can be used to
it's good.
Transparency filling.
Okay. Thank you very much.